Welcome to Wicked Housewives on Cape Cod, Living the Dream, a show that celebrates ordinary people who do extraordinary things. Hear what motivated them to attain their goals. See which circumstances molded their character and turned them into everyday heroes. Learn more about this show and the hosts for Wicked Housewives on Cape Cod TV and radio on Facebook. Now here are your hosts, the Wicked Housewives on Cape Cod, Kathleen O'Keefe Cannabis and Lori Boyle.
Hello, and welcome to our show today, Wicked Housewives on Cape Cod. I'm Lori Boyle, and we have a great show for you. Kat Cannabis is here as well as a Wicked Housewife. And we are going to meet a panel of women who are involved in the first women's conference on Cape Cod. It'll be March 5th in Falmouth at the Seacrest Hotel. To my right is Marie Blackburn. She is a wife, mother, and owner of Simply Black and White Catering and Events. Marie is a graduate of Johnson & Wales, owns her own business. Marie has also volunteered countless hours as chair of Mashpee Housing Authority and a board member on the YMCA, just to name a few of her volunteer activities. Next is Nancy Feth. She is a professional coach. She has been helping individuals, couples, businesses, and teams to connect for almost 10 years. She and her partners have just launched Simply Grace, which is a women's community, and she's going to tell us more about that. And to her right is Melissa Murphy. She's a certified transformational coach and founding partner of Insights of Success. She helps individuals, families, and businesses build their dreams, accelerate their results, and focus on the possibilities. And to her right is our other Wicked Housewife, Kat Cannabis. Welcome, everybody.
Thank you.
Welcome,
thank you.
Ladies. Yeah, so Marie, why did you come to Cape Cod?
About 27 years ago, I came to Cape Cod as a young mom. I had my first child when I was 19 years old, and I left him here with my mother's sister, my eldest aunt, to pursue my education. So after I completed my education, I wanted a place that was quiet and lovely and beautiful to raise children. So mm-hmm. I came to Cape Cod after summering here for most of my childhood as well.
So you knew Cape Cod from when you were a child?
Yes.
You know, we see that a lot, Lori. A lot of people who end up coming back to Cape Cod, we're here as children, and we're addicted to the magic here.
That's right. I mean, there's a lot of people who just love being here. They come back year after year, and it's fabulous. And Marie was telling me one of the reasons that she wanted to do the conferences March was to help the businesses that are seasonal with the seasonal planning, and because, you know, their business kind of drops off in the winter, but we're going to mm-hmm. do something about that with the conference, hopefully. So, Nancy, what's your role in the conference?
So I'm bringing the awareness of collaboration mm-hmm. to the team, mm-hmm. kind of a silent player in the background, mm-hmm. Just helping the nuances between what we're trying to do, what we're visioning for, and mm-hmm. what's trying to happen.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. You have a coaching business, mm-hmm. and you focus on relationships, mm-hmm. is that right?
That's correct.
Tell us about your business a little bit. How do you facilitate their relationships, and in what way?
Well, the most important thing is to try to have people bring awareness to what's happening as it's happening, mm-hmm. and then mm-hmm. what is trying to happen. So mm-hmm. there's usually all kinds of things going on that trigger us or have us feel like things are going well, to start mm-hmm. to pay attention to that and facilitate conversation from that place.
Mm-hmm. And that's where relationships always start, from conversation, right?
Conversations mm-hmm. and self-awareness. Really yeah. important, the self-awareness piece.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Oh, definitely, mm-hmm. yeah. You would agree with that when you can?
Oh, yes, absolutely. You know, you build your relationship from the moment you say hi and your eyes meet. So much like Melissa and I, we had never met each other before. We had our first little meeting for the conference. So Melissa, tell us your story about why you moved here to beautiful Cape Cod.
I was in a transition in my life, and I moved down to follow a career. And it was a gift, really. Where I was beautiful for a time being, but when I got here, I looked at my husband in 2006 and I sitting down at the beautiful beach that we live near, and I said, why did we wait so long? Beautiful place, why did we wait? And so now we get to live where lots of people just vacation, mm-hmm. and we want people to know to come all year, not mm-hmm. just in the summer.
Mm-hmm. Mm. And that's great. And my husband used to come to Cape Cod to vacation from the time he was a little tiny boy, because he was born and raised in Boston and Newton. And so the first time he brought me here, I said, yes, this is where I want to live. This is it. Mm-hmm. And so we did. We moved from Florida, and we bought our house up here. And, you know, there's nowhere else in the world like Cape Cod. And I've been all over the world because I am a military brat. And so when Marie asked me to be the keynote speaker for this conference, because it was Cape Cod, I said, how can I say no? I mean, my gosh, I just love this place. So I was so excited to have been asked. I was so surprised, never even occurred to me. And so thank you for that, because I love to be in service yes. to Cape Cod. And of course, Lori, you know, you're in the background here also, putting all of this together and getting the conference out mm-hmm. also through our TV show here. So.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Yeah. And the other thing I want to ask you, Marie, is tell me about your business, your event planning and your catering, because on your Facebook page are the most beautiful pictures of the food you prepared and the way you service the table and those things. So can you tell us a little bit about what you do?
Sure. We are Simply Black and White Catering is a multi-generational catering and event planning company. I work closely with my 33-year-old son, Ralph, who has a business degree and a culinary degree. What we bring to the table, so to speak, is that home feeling. So we're in-home caterers. Mm-hmm. We come into your home, your office, or your venue. And a lot of people spend a lifetime collecting beautiful dishes and housewares, but really don't know how to showcase them when it's time to entertain mm-hmm. Guests. So what we bring is we take your party up a level. Uh-huh. That's what we specialize mm-hmm. in. Our displays are legendary, really. People really appreciate that extra touch that we bring to the table. So I raised my son here on Cape Cod trying to make a living, and he watched me and what I did and grew up to really have a passion for that. So we're still at it, and we are booking holiday parties right now, which is an important thing.
Oh, that's fantastic. That's great. Well, you're a big party giver yourself, Kat.
I love to party. I love to play hostess. I always did that. I was the first one to have little tea parties when I was in kindergarten. So mm-hmm. I do really appreciate that. And now, you know, you're doing it as an adult, and it's even more fun because yes. you don't have your mom going, don't spill that water in the tea party. You need to spill whatever you want and clean it up later. Mm-hmm. So tell me what your role is going to be for the conference. What is it you're bringing to the conference and doing and hoping to achieve?
Okay. So in addition to the catering, we do event planning. I've planned many events for many organizations over the years. Being a mom for so many years, for 33 years, there really hasn't been a time that I had for myself to really do something big. So my vision as the event planner, I am the dreamer of this conference and the event planner, and my role is to coordinate the best of, to bring to Cape Cod the best of what we have in the surrounding areas, to inspire women, mm-hmm. to get women to dream like I have, that there is them to live out their passions, their hopes, and their dreams. So I just kind of stepped into this role and just have been embraced by so many wonderful men and women who mm-hmm. are lending their talents to this mm-hmm. This event, and there's a lot of coordination that goes into this, but I'm using all of my skills and resources that I've acquired over the years, and I really see this as a first, and I'm looking forward
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
you know?
Yeah. I see this as being very successful.
Yeah, I do.
Really,
too.
Lori.
I mean,
there's so much love and passion that's going into this. Mm-hmm. And it's, you know, sort of like our tagline, living the dream.
Right.
She's living the dream and bringing it to mm-hmm. everybody else on the Cape. And so for that reason, Marie, thank you so much.
Yeah,
you're giving everybody a chance to live their dream as well.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And speaking of living their dream, Nancy, you have Simply Grace. You've mm-hmm. started Simply Grace. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Oh,
and
yeah.
What that is?
That's a dream. That's okay. a dream that's been yeah. in the making for a good 10 years to a lifetime for my partners and I. Mm-hmm. It's a women's community, basically. And mm-hmm. it's about helping to inspire and empower women through mm-hmm. the connection that we are. The relationships that we do so naturally, we get to actually support each other in doing that. So. Mm-hmm. I'm just jazzed that it's a brand new company. We're an online community and we're creating a boutique. And we just have a presence here to help the relationship aspect of the conference. So mm-hmm. Just really pleased.
Oh, that's mm-hmm. really fantastic. Mm-hmm. And you have a great t-shirt.
We do have a great t-shirt.
Too, that I
we
just
do have a great t-shirt. Well, the motto is to scatter seeds of joy. And we do it by being kind, be compassionate, and be love. And I think women do this all the time. We do it with our families and our communities. But now it's like, let's wear it proudly, ladies. And let's have people ask us, like, what's that about?
Uh-huh.
And start to have conversations. Mm. So, yeah. Thank you for that.
Sure.
So, Melissa, tell us, what's your role going to be? Because the more we're hearing here, I know I'm getting more excited because this is just awesome. I mean, women doing this conference for women, by women. You know, on Cape Cod, it doesn't get any better than that.
No, it doesn't. So I am so honored, and what a privilege it is that Marie asked me to be on her advisory board. Marie and I met, and like we were just talking about, relationships just automatic, right?
Mm-hmm.
And women have a great ability of just tapping in to each mm-hmm. other's souls. And Marie and I met, and 2 days later, we sat and chatted at Panera Bread, of all places. And Marie said, I have a dream. And due to the fact that what I do for a living is I bring those people to know their dream can be their reality, mm-hmm. I leaned in and said, what is it? Mm-hmm. And she was so eloquent in saying, I see all these women gathering together and we empower them and inspire them. And mm-hmm. I said, great, when's it gonna be? And just in those simple conversation over about an hour, the conference got launched. Marie said, I want you to be a part of this. And I'm just so privileged to be a part of the team mm-hmm. and meeting these amazing women on Cape Cod that I have mm-hmm. met mm-hmm. that have so much to bring to their families, their community, and really themselves.
Mm-hmm.
So
mm-hmm. That's so true. And you know what really impressed me, Lori, was this was moving so fast, and you and I are fast movers.
Yeah.
You know, we get an idea, and it's done before we finish the sentence, because that's the way we move. And we found in Marie the same thing. Mm-hmm. We met mm-hmm. her, and within a few minutes, we had already planned the TV show. Suddenly, I was going to be a keynote speaker, which surprised me. But then, she doesn't just talk the talk. She also walks the walk uh-huh. because I find out that she's already been at a meeting at 7:30 this morning.
Oh, my goodness. Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
I'm
yeah,
like, oh, my fantastic. Goodness, this woman really does do mm-hmm. what she says she's going to do. And the other thing that I love about this conference being here is Cape Cod is a destination place. And there are so many women and families that are here all summer long, but they feel they don't have a reason to come back in the winter. Mm-hmm. But they're not that far. They're just over the bridge like you, just over the bridge. Mm-hmm. They're in Rhode Island. They're, you know, maybe in Boston.
Uh-huh.
They would come back for this if they knew about it. So we want to make sure that we get this message out
absolutely.
And say, come yeah. join us uh-huh. on Cape Cod in the winter where there is no traffic. You no longer need a reservation in the restaurants. And it's beautiful. Mm-hmm. Cape Cod in the winter. It reminds me of the musical Brigadoon.
Mm-hmm.
It's just gorgeous with the fog and the snow. Not too much snow, just a little snow. And you get to bundle up and get around the fireplace. There's just nowhere else like that. There mm-hmm. just isn't with the waters. Oh.
No, it is. It's absolutely a beautiful, picturesque place, even in the winter. And And speaking of Marie, you've been just like a magnet, you know, for all these women to come to you and say, what can I do? How can I help? You know, and being part of that whole situation that everyone is kind of coming together, and I'm meeting so many wonderful people, it's just been a real blessing to have you even think about this conference.
Thank you.
So, can you tell me a little bit more about like those synergistic things that are happening with you since you've mentioned this?
Sure. I understand I guess it begins with understanding your purpose in mm-hmm. life, and I think I understand mine to inspire. So for the last few years since my children have, you know, gotten older and grown up, I kind of identified what it is that I'm meant to do. And I remember one day recently standing up at a meeting a couple of years ago and saying, I am a business connector. And from that moment on, I stepped into that role. And I began to meet with men and women across Cape Cod relationally over coffee in public places. Mm-hmm. And what I did was build up a lot of social capital. Mm-hmm. I have the ability to pick up the phone and ask for what I need, and also to be a real giver. I connect people together, and they're doing business together, or I'm able to give referrals to each other. It just creates an atmosphere where people want to be around you, especially when you're giving. Mm-hmm. So I think I have a giving nature, and I really, to the bottom of my heart, believe in community. I was raised with a sense of community, that we're all connected one way or another. So it's really natural for me. And I think people are drawn to that giving spirit, mm-hmm. and that's what I want to be. So it's just a calling, and I understand it, and I'm honored to do it. And I'm really pleased to bring the first. I just know I have something bigger to do, and mm-hmm. it involves a lot of people.
Mm-hmm.
So.
And you've already started it.
Yes, I did. Yes. We hit the ground running. You know, my tagline, actually, it's in line with yours, is to live out loud.
Uh-huh.
And someone mm-hmm. said to me that you're living out loud in your older years. And, mm-hmm. and yes, it's my time.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. That's mm-hmm. wonderful. And yeah, our tagline is living the dream. And mm-hmm. this is your dream. And you pulled us all into your dream. And we love that. I'm such a dreamer. Uh-huh. But I think what I'd like to know also, just going down the line, is what gets you up in the morning? What is your energy? What is that thing that makes you throw those covers off rather than curling up or pulling them over your head and going, I've got to get up because I have to live this dream by doing this? What mm-hmm. what is that? How would you finish that? That question or
I'm
statement.
The kind of person who hits the ground running. When mm-hmm. I wake up, there is no, there's none of that, and there's never have been for me. I get up to serve, and I have a saying that the world's run by those who show up. Mm-hmm. And I, like you said, that 7:30 morning that I, 7:30 meeting that I attend every Thursday morning.
That means she gets up way earlier than 7:30.
For Mashpee Kiwanis, I'm the kind of person whose house is in order and the bed's made and food is ready for breakfast, lunch, or dinner before I leave the house. It's important to come home to a nice place and then go out and serve in my community and work mm-hmm. hard. Mm-hmm. So I think the work ethic, the community really... the family really drives me to wake up and just to want to be a better than I was yesterday.
Great. Wonderful. What about you? What gets you up in the morning?
Yeah, the connection. Totally the connection. Mm-hmm. Who am I going to talk with today? Mm-hmm. Who am I going to have an experience with? I mean, same thing when I met Marie was through a relationship where I had met another woman who met another woman and passed it on and, check out what they're doing on Cape Cod. And yeah. It was like connection immediately. And mm-hmm. we talked. Mm-hmm. And I remember it was a Sunday night. We were on from like 9 to 10 o'clock at mm-hmm. night. And we were talking and talking and going deeper and faster. And what jazzed me about the conference is just women do this naturally, uh-huh. you know? So I like to be out there just connecting and mm-hmm. doing conversations.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, it's just.
That's what, yes, great. And mm-hmm. Melissa, what gets you out of that bed in the morning, that warm bed, especially now?
Well, I will tell you that I always got out of bed, but I didn't always get out of bed the way I do today. I got out of bed previously because you had to. Mm-hmm. You had to get to work, you had to do the things that many mm-hmm. of us women have to do. Mm-hmm. I now get out of bed knowing that I really was put here on this earth mm-hmm. to do something. And it was to do something bigger. And it was yeah. to inspire people mm-hmm. to want to do something bigger than what they originally thought they were capable of. Mm-hmm. And I no longer live by default. Uh-huh. I live by the design. You know, mm-hmm. if I want to do something, I write it down and I put one foot in front of the other. And mm-hmm. so like a baby learns how to walk by putting one foot in front of the mm-hmm. other, that's what I do. And now mm-hmm. I get up and I get very excited of who am I going to meet in all arenas of mm-hmm. my life, whether it be at the grocery store, smiling at another person in the store mm-hmm. and getting to meet them. So mm-hmm. that connection, that, right. that connection that we all have. Mm-hmm.
So Lori, in like 30 seconds or less, what gets you up in the morning?
Oh, my alarm clock usually. But really it is, it's the synergistic relationship with you, Kat. That
she knows she's going to call me and wake me up.
Yeah. No pressure, Kat.
But that we, you know, we have started our show and we also have the radio network, and things have moved so fast since we decided to embark on this. Mm-hmm. You know, we've taped about almost 20 shows in about 6 weeks. So, I mean, we have been just moving,
we've
moving,
moving. We've been moving really fast.
And it's been fun, mm-hmm. you know, and it's been exciting, and mm-hmm. to watch it all grow and see people like us on Facebook and
yeah,
all
our
that
Facebook,
kind of stuff.
Yeah,
it's
so
like, oh my God,
go to our Facebook page, yeah, Wicked right. Housewives on Cape Cod. It's and amazing. So many people are liking us, yeah. and this was before we even were putting shows up on there. I was like, why do they like me? But, you know, what gets me up in the morning? Well, first of all, the smell of coffee. That'll do it every time. My husband will bring in a cappuccino and put it under my nose, and I'm like, bing! And then the second thing is going downstairs into my library, turning on my emails, finding out what Lori and I are going to do that day, and making those connections. Mm-hmm. So thank you for joining us in the first half of this roundtable discussion on the conference that's going to be here on Cape Cod. And give us the exact wording for that, Marie.
It's called the Cape Cod's First Conference for Women. And this year's theme is Driven mm-hmm. Women.
Driven Women. Join us for part two. This is Kat Canavis and Lori Boyle of the Wicked Housewives on Cape Cod saying, don't go away. Look for part two. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
Thank you for joining Lori Boyle and Kathleen Kat O'Keefe Canavis on Wicked Housewives on Cape Cod. Don't forget to like us on Facebook for our show updates, and join us next time when we showcase more everyday heroes.